What's up, YouTubers? It is Keith. I'm going to make a quick video. I'm going to try and make this quick. If you guys have noticed, I've changed my YouTube channel name. And I've tried to do this once before, but I don't know. It stayed changed for a little while, and then it went back to my old name, which was Feathermucker1. If you guys are wondering why I have that name and how that how I got that name, you guys can look. I think I made a video about that before, prior. But that's not what this is about. The reason why I changed my name, and it looks like it's staying, to Light Out of Darkness now, is because I do watch a lot of other videos, and I comment, and I don't want people to see my name and be, stumbled or turned off because it, or think that my comment is coming from an immature view. So I did change my name. And so it's Light Out of Darkness, and that was my name prior to when I tried to change it last time, about a year ago or so, maybe more than that. But nevertheless, I changed it now, and it looks like this is going to stay, hopefully now, God willing. But the reason why I went from Light Out of Darkness, because now that you guys have know a little bit more about me in depth. And that's a lot of stuff I covered in a couple of videos, but you can see how it applies to me personally, and so that's why I changed it. But I want to share with you two scriptures that I was reading last night, and just bear with me, you guys. Just listen to me. Just even if you're not into the Bible, just this applies to why I changed my name, and it just was amazing because I literally just changed my name this week, and reading the scriptures last night, it the exact wording came. I read it, and it was amazing because I really didn't derive my Light Out of Darkness from the Bible, you guys. It's just one that was kind of just sitting on me, and I wanted to use that because I've been through a lot, you guys. You guys can probably imagine, and so I think that name applies to myself, bringing that light out of darkness. And when I was reading my Bible last night, I read it, and it was a Holy Spirit, but I know that it just blew me away, and I want to share it so much so that I want to share it with you guys, my viewers. So I am going to read that verse. It's in out of the New King James Version. That's the Bible I referred to. I just resonate with it, and it's easy for me to read and understand and retain knowledge from the scriptures in this translation. Far more better than the New World Translation that the Jehovah's Witnesses use. And I have the King James Version as well, and the Living Version. And so I have other Bibles, but I always go back to the New King James Version. So I'm going to read what I read last night, and I'm not going to read the whole scriptures I read last night, but I'm going to read you what kind of hit me and resonated with me that I want to share with you. So it's taken from the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and 4, but the one I'm going to share with you is in chapter 4. And this chapter was towards the first Christians in Paul's ministry and spreading the gospel and starting the body of Christ, building up the body of Christ in the church. So I want to read to you guys what I read last night, and this starts in chapter 4 of 2 Corinthians, verse 6. It says, "For it is the God who commanded light to shine out of darkness, who has shone in our hearts to give the light of knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ." Whew, that's heavy. That hit me pretty heavy last night. And I want to read it to you guys again. It says, "For it is the God who commanded light to shine out of darkness, who has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ." So, you guys, that just kind of blew me away that I read that, because it's the light out of darkness, and move, man. So I wanted to share that with you guys because I thought it was a trip. But the whole chapter is just goes on about how that God is within us, lives within us, and it's through Jesus Christ, and we have to spread it and it's stay positive, because it says in chapter 4, verse 2, it says, "But we have renounced the hidden things of shame, not walking in craftiness or handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God." It's just heavy. And on the topic of that, because of the Jehovah's Witnesses and how they just, when you leave that organization, it just brings you shame. Like, you feel shame. And that wasn't God's intention. He doesn't want that. To the handling of the Word of God deceitfully, like Jehovah's Witnesses do. They'll take certain scriptures they'll pull certain scriptures to benefit them in moving forward and pressing these non-doctrinal practices that they do. And in chapter 3, verses 16, it says, "Nevertheless, when one turns to the Lord, the veil is taken away. Now the Lord is a spirit, and where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty." There's freedom. Now a veil covers a face, and it hides. It's covered. It's not transparent. It's a veil. It's very hard to see through a veil, a physical veil. So it says, when the veil is lifted, you understand that there's freedom. You're not living blindly, stumbling about. "Nevertheless, when the one turns to the Lord, not to the governing body, not to the faithful and discreet slave, but to the Lord. When one turns to the Lord, the veil is taken away." You see things clearer. You see things how they are intended to see. "Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty." You guys, I can't tell you how much that just can apply to an ex-Jehovah's Witness that leaves the organization and pursues a relationship with Christ Jesus. They find liberty. They find true liberty. And so I urge you guys to draw close to God, draw close to Jesus Christ, pray continuously, and the Lord is faithful, and He will answer those who are sincere, because He knows the heart. See, God sees those who with an outward, men see people with an outward appearance, but God sees what men cannot see. So as long as you're earnest and sincere, He will come to your aid. So I thought it was a trip that I changed my name this week, and I read that scripture last night, and I wanted to share it with you guys just to show you that, light does come out of darkness. No matter how hard or how troubled our past is, God loves us all. And when you leave an organization like Jehovah's Witnesses, you continue to pursue your faith in Christ Jesus, you will find that liberty. And you will feel renewed and reborn. And everything that you hear about is real. It's legit. It's life transforming. So God bless you guys. Thank you for all the love and support. I appreciate all the subscriptions, all the new subscriptions, all the thumbs up and comments. Stay with me, you guys. I will share with you what is shared with me. And hopefully it'll inspire some of you. There's motivational videos to get in shape. There's motivational videos to pursue endeavors. But the only motivation, the true motivation to happiness, is in the pages of this book right here. So seek God, and He will seek you. Take care, you guys. Much love and respect. And I will see you in the next video. And like I say, in my videos, it doesn't matter what happens around you, but what matters is what happens within you. Take care. God bless. Much love.